experiment all kinds of music, from jazz, classical, to contemporary, to European, you name it. I've collaborated with harp, with percussionist, with all sorts of music. But there's one category that I have never tried, that is Chinese music. Even though I was born in China, playing a Chinese music on a Western instrument, cello, is not so common. In fact, it's very difficult. Several reasons. There hasn't been a very good composer can manage to put the simplicity of Chinese music into such a complicated instrument. They will not be able to utilize the different sound, the different effects of this instrument. But today, I'm going to play this special piece by Sheng. It's called The Seven Tunes Heard in China. This piece was composed in 1985 and was premiered not far away from here in Orange County by Yu Yu Ma. This piece is written in such a way, divided into seven movements. Each movement is from a different province with a different cultural background. So the first one is called The Seasons and it's from Qinghai. This province is known to have a very beautiful and large lake in the middle. And as you might know, the Chinese culture, spring has a very special meaning among all the four seasons because it means life, means gathering together, means spring festival. So it's always a very upbeat, happy song. Following that, it's a song called Guessing Song from Yunnan. It's actually close to where I'm from and happened to be where one of Aika's parents is from. Their culture known to have this kind of flirtish song with lyrics that you might already see from the program notes that doesn't really tell you what it is, but all of your imaginations. So here comes the first result. It's a song called Little Cabbage. The Little Cabbage is the name of this orphanage girl who lost both of her parents during the war. And she was called Little Cabbage because she always wear a green pants and a white shirt. So if you look at her, she looks like an upside down cabbage. The whole song is meant to sing with a crying tone. And you might find the entire song has no up phrase because every phrase is a crying description of how bad and how sad her life is. Following that is Drunken, Fisherman. This piece was meant to play an Asian instrument called Qin. It's basically a table harp with less strings than now. And all the Qin music you might find is very close to what Impressionism is like. It's not about the melody, it's not even about the rhythm, but it's about the atmosphere that it creates with the resonance. Here comes Little Cabbage and Drunken Fisherman. Thank you. Diu Diu Dang is from Taiwan. This is a time where the train was first introduced, and the local people have never seen something like this. So the whole song is about imitating the weird sound the first heard about train. Following that is Pastoral Ballade. It's one of my favorite. It is called, it's from Mongolia. If you ever seen any of the picture of Mongolia, you will see it is all white grassland with countless of cows, sheep, and people there are very open-minded. The whole thing is written in a way for such an instrument called the horsehead instrument or makouqing. It is perhaps one of the only instruments, a string and bowed instrument that I know, you play not by pressing down the string with the tip of your finger, but instead you use the fingernail to push the string.
Thank you.
Now it comes to the last side, the Tibetan dance. Tibet is one of the largest provinces of China, and their culture is so different from what normally you see as a Han race. They have their own language, they have their own religion, and also they have their own rhythm. This piece utilizes the drum that is from the Tibetan culture to, as a sub-melody, to counter the melody you're about to hear in this piece. Again, I'd like to thank all of you for being here today. Right after the recital, we have In and Out as a reception on the fifth floor. Special thanks to Rico and her mom, Aika, Lucy, for helping out. Without them, this recital won't be possible. So here comes the Tibetan dance.